Jen, that automated call reminded parents to keep their kids out of school if they're feeling sick at all, not to share drinks, to wash their hands. And staff at the school says this is the worst absentee rate they've seen in their careers.
Hello, this is Chris Andriski, principal of Newmarket Junior Senior High School. I'm calling to inform every parent.
It was Monday when that recorded phone call went out, alerting parents that the number of students going home sick at Newmarket Junior Senior High School was growing, and it's continued to grow at an alarming rate.
On Monday, we had 127 kids out. Yesterday was 144, and today I'm up to 160.
With a student body of 513, that means 31% of students are out sick.
In my 13 years in education, I've never seen numbers like this.
Principal Chris Andriski says teachers are now required to leave windows open at the end of the day. Janitors are wiping all doorknobs and handles. Amidst the effort, students are still missing days of classes.
He missed 2 days because he had it over the weekend, but the fever broke last night, and he just has the cough.
This mother's son is back in school, but other children have been missing up to 5 days.
Teachers are finding that they're doing a lot of review because some of the kids that are out on Monday are now coming back on Wednesday.
Teachers are now posting assignments on websites as fellow students look from empty desk to empty desk.
Most of them are absent.
Do you know why?
Because most of them are sick.
If the nurse's office continues to be flooded with sick children, the principal says they may have to take drastic measures.
If it continues to push and rise, tomorrow or Friday, that we'd close down for a little period to kind of let this incubation period, cease.
Now, teachers and staff have also been calling out sick, but it's improving slightly. 16 out on Monday, 9 out today. Ironically, the principal tells us because of the economy, there are more than enough substitute teachers on standby. Reporting live in Portsmouth, Korea Sakakini, WMUR News 9.